To understand what makes a great soccer team great, you can't consider the individual players alone. You need to understand how they coordinate and interact, the net effect of them coming together. Interestingly, understanding molecules is not so different. This is Real Chem. Instead of soccer teams, let's compare two similar molecules by looking at their individual bonds to better understand the molecule as a whole. Sometimes in chemistry, we must bring together our learning from a number of areas. This is one of them. Use it as an opportunity to test your grasp of the different aspects of molecular and electronic structure. Vamos a mirar juntos. Let's explore. Consider the molecules sulfur trioxide and sulfur dioxide, two superficially similar substances. One is a colorless gas at room temperature, and the other is a white crystalline solid. The Lewis structure of sulfur trioxide is sulfur and oxygen each have 6 valence electrons, so 24 in all. Because sulfur is less electronegative, it goes in the middle. Now, let's put in lone pairs on each oxygen. The sulfur doesn't have an octet, so let's convert a lone pair on one of these oxygens to a bonding pair. But remember, sulfur is able to expand its octet. It will do this if it can minimize the formal charges. If we assign formal charges to the atoms in this Lewis structure, we find the two oxygens each have a -1 formal charge, and sulfur has a +2 charge. Not great. If we convert 2 more lone pairs to bonding pairs, the formal charges on every atom goes to 0. So sulfur will happily expand its octet to minimize the formal charges. In this structure, the sulfur has 3 electron domains, so it has a trigonal planar electron group geometry. There are no lone pairs on the sulfur. All 3 groups of electron density are bonds. Therefore, the molecular shape of sulfur trioxide is trigonal planar. Finally, the 3 bond moments all cancel out. Sulfur trioxide is therefore nonpolar. Now, let's do the same analysis for a very similar molecule, sulfur dioxide. Sulfur and oxygen each have 6 valence electrons, so 18 in all. Sulfur is less electronegative, so it goes in the middle. Now, let's put in lone pairs on each oxygen. We have only used 16 electrons, so let's put a lone pair on the sulfur to get up to 18. The sulfur doesn't have an octet, so let's convert a lone pair on one of the oxygens to a bonding pair. But again, remember that sulfur is able to expand its octet. In this Lewis structure, the sulfur has a +1 formal charge and oxygen has a -1 formal charge. We can reduce these both to 0 by converting an oxygen lone pair to a bonding pair. Just like sulfur trioxide, the sulfur again has 3 electron domains. The electron group geometry is trigonal planar. However, unlike sulfur trioxide, one of the electron domains is a lone pair, so the molecular shape of sulfur dioxide is bent. Finally, the 2 bond moments don't cancel out. As a result, there is a net dipole moment, and the sulfur dioxide is polar. To understand the differences between sulfur trioxide and sulfur dioxide, we need to look beyond the sulfur-oxygen bonds themselves and consider how these bonds play together in the molecules. It's like analyzing a great play in soccer. It only makes sense when you consider how the players work together. So explore and remember to have fun.